Hey guys, what's up? This is Bharat. You're watching iGyan, and today we've got a really special package here from HP. We're going to be unboxing and taking a first look at the new HP Spectre Folio. So let's quickly get started. Now, HP's series of laptops are exclusively premium devices and they're designed for higher end consumption and usage. The new HP Spectre Folio is no different and it comes in at a price of 1,99,990, which is the suggested retail price, which includes GST. Of course, you'll get a little bit of a discount on this and I'll leave links into buying this awesome product if you guys are interested in checking it out. Now, let's talk about the packaging. In the first, you get this external box, which if we remove the packaging from this and open it up, we do get an inner box inside this. The packaging is really high-end and extremely premium, and you will thoroughly enjoy the unboxing experience. Once you prop open the internal box, you will find that the first thing inside is the laptop, and it is covered in this microfiber cover. It is a dust cover for your folio, and just from holding it, you know that it's really thin and lightweight. But I'm going to place this to the side for the time being, and I'm going to go further in. Once we go further in, you can see that we do have a box which contains a few bits of paper documentation, and you also have the pen holder which has been tucked in over there nicely. Next up, you will get the wall charger. Now, the wall charger comes without prongs because it does have dual options available. You can directly plug it into the wall using the single prong that is available, or alternatively, you can use the extended cable with the dual prongs at the end that you can use to sort of extend the adapter and plug it into your machine. Now, the adapter has a USB-C port on one end, so it allows you to charge via the several USB-C ports available on the device. Now, you will also get the HP Spectre Folio Pen. Now, this is included inside the box, and it is a rather ingenious product. It does have a few features, including pressure sensitivity and dual inputs along with a button, and this thing opens up and charges via a USB-C port, which is also fantastic because you can use the same charger as your laptop to charge up the pen. Now, let's remove the Spectre Folio from the microfiber dust cloth, and immediately you can see that this thing is a completely unique product because it is covered entirely in leather. The back, the bottom, and the trackpad area is all covered in leather to give this machine a unique look, a premium look, and it is still extremely slim and extremely portable and extremely lightweight. So this is definitely an upmarket feeling device, and the leather looks absolutely amazing and surprisingly shocking with the way that it's been designed. Once you prop open the HP Spectre, you'll be able to see that you can hold it in several positions. So you can tilt it up to use it as a traditional laptop, and you get a full keyboard for that as well. Or you can prop it in slightly to use it as a tablet, or you can flatten it out completely to use it as a flat tablet. So you have several stand options, and the greatest thing about this is the display. So this is a 13.3 inch full HD IPS micro edge LED display. It is a 1920 by 1080p display for a price of approximately 2 lakh rupees. I would have liked to see a 4K display, but this is a really nice 1080p display with a WLED backlit, and it is a touchscreen which does have Gorilla Glass 4 on the front. It is 400 nits in terms of brightness, and it is a 1 watt display panel with a 72% color gamut. The display has great viewing angles and especially good for consuming video content. It's not very reflective, so it's easy to use and easy to view. The touchscreen is also really responsive, and it also accepts pen input, which we will talk about in just a minute. Now, just above the display is also dual noise cancellation microphones and a front-facing camera, which can be used as your web camera. It does have an 88 degree field of view. Now, if you just move below the display, you will see the keyboard. Now, this is a really nice and tactile keyboard. For the thinness of the laptop that you have over here, the keyboard has great travel and good amount of feedback when you're typing on it. It's actually a really comfortable keyboard to type on. Below that, you also have a full multi-touch trackpad, which again is really responsive, really easy to use, and you can see everything around it is wrapped in leather. If you look towards the right of the HP Spectre Folio, you will find two USB-C ports. One of them is a Thunderbolt 3 port, so you can connect your Thunderbolt peripherals if that's something that you're looking to do. On the left side, you will also find a USB-C port along with a headphone jack that is actually on the display side. So once you open this up, it twists and removes itself completely from the bottom bit, and inside you can see the several modes in which you can use it, but it is a completely slim device and it looks absolutely fantastic. Now this particular machine has an Intel Core i7-8500Y processor with a 1.5 GHz base frequency, but goes all the way up to 4.2 GHz as far as the clock speed is concerned. You do get a 512 GB M2 NVMe SSD preloaded and a 6-cell battery that promises up to 12 hours of usage on the machine. Inside is also 16 GB of LPDDR3 RAM, and it is not upgradable, so if you do decide to buy this machine, you have to get the specifications that you want right out of the box, because you will not be able to upgrade any of these things. In total, there are two Thunderbolt 3 ports and a USB-C port, which is a 3.1 Gen 1 port. You also have a one headphone and microphone combo, which is on the display. Now, one of the coolest things about this is the Bang & Olufsen speakers that are preloaded. So you do get Bang & Olufsen quad speakers, which you can see a whole speaker strip right above the keyboard area. And these are really loud and really nice speakers. So if you're consuming content or listening to music on this machine, you'll be thoroughly surprised with the quality of audio and the sound that this machine can produce being so slim as it is. Now, because the screen is touch friendly, you can use finger input, or alternatively, you can use the pen. The pen is really good for taking notes or drawing sketches if that's something that you're into. I'm not that good with using my pens. I'm more of a typing person. But if you are an artist or a person who likes to draw or sketch or take notes on their machine, pen will definitely come in handy for you. You can use both the front and the rear end of the pen. So for example, you can use the front to sort of draw or take notes, and you can use the rear to remove those notes or to erase content from the display. For some weird reason, we decided to try and do some gaming on this, even though this doesn't have a discrete GPU. It does use the Intel Core i7's inbuilt GPU, but there is no discrete GPU, and the gaming performance was quite poor. In fact, if you're planning to play even games like PUBG, you will not be able to do that. And this laptop, in all honesty, is not designed for that. And if you're a person who's going to be buying this machine, you're probably one of those guys who plays more Solitaire or Minesweeper and not PUBG. But if you're planning on doing any kind of high-end gaming on this, you'll probably need to attach an external GPU, which you can, because this does have the Thunderbolt 3 ports. So that was a quick look at the new HP Spectre Folio, a really fantastic upmarket, super premium leather-wrapped laptop from HP. Really slim, really unique, a great battery life, great display, touchscreen with a great keyboard, extreme portability, if that's something that you're looking for. Links in the description if you guys like it. If you like this video, guys, don't forget to smash the like button, hit the subscribe button if you want to look at some more really cool, unique laptops in the future. This has been Bharat for iGAN Network. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one. I don't know if what we had was just a waste of time. You got 70,000 friends, but I am one of